Hello there, everybody. Welcome back to more Smite SPL games. This match, we're going to be bringing you the 3v3 finals coming to you from Team Boopy versus the Elysian Uprising. Interesting games coming out from these two teams so far. Fireheart Axel has had some phenomenal games. At the same time, Arcado has had some phenomenal plays as well. Really, this game's going to come down between the two. First two bans coming out, Scylla already. We know that Bronzio can play that incredibly well, and Barkus. Dijo has had some phenomenal attempts with this setup on Barkus, and especially in Joust, this is really going to come through as well. And that's why we're seeing another ban targeting out that. This time we're going to see Ares. Again, those chains just make things so much more problematic. And instead as well, not just chains we're going to see as well, but that ultimate, forcing out those relics to either buy beads or burn the ultimates, which is so much more useful. And especially in this Joust meta, these 3v3s, it's a lot more explosive. Things are a lot more condensed. There's not so much farm that you can find anywhere else. In fact, actually, we're going to see Odin come out as well. A nice safe pick. We know that there are people in Joust who have this in their back pocket. And so, as a result, just taking that away, it eliminates a lot of pressure because whilst everything is condensed, there's still a little bit of room, and Odin really takes that away, especially in the early game. The high clear pressure, it just lets the team snowball out further. So we're going to see the Hobwar comes out, and yes, we are going to see that locked in. Most likely, that is going to go to Jackie, and in straight response, we're looking at a Poseidon as well. Both of these two for mages is phenomenal picks. These both enable high amounts of burst and a fair amount of control coming out. Hobwar with his Atlas of the Yellow River, since it covers pretty much the entire length of the lane, that is fantastic slow, lets a lot of setup potential come through, and an Amuzen Carb. Now, this is spicy. Amuzen Carb is very, very good in this smaller map, where you can get the Mies with the bees sitting around. You've got the hives, they're all very, very condensed, so you don't have to worry about that too much. You can hide them over the wall over on the left hand side, and we're gonna see straight Aura picked up for Jackie. This is a pick that I like to watch Fireheart go on to. This is his god. This guy, very good with this god. Lot of setup potential just from these two. Good early game pressure coming out from here, and the Hobwar can transition this if this goes a little bit later. But that being said, the Elysian Uprising, they do have that Amuzen Carb. And Amuzen Carb loves to box. You have a very high amount of clear coming out right now from the Elysian Uprising. So it's going to come down to see exactly where Boop goes with this. Dijo does have some picks available. It does look like we're going to see that tanky front line. So it's going to be interesting to see where these bans come out as well. We've already seen Kumbakana get banned away as well. Another very potent pick. And basically, we're just going to see what kind of setup that could be lost. DJ still has options with Geb. Works quite nicely in on the Poseidon. We see a Kabrakan pick again. Or Banaway in this case. Very nice pick. It's a lot of early pressure and a lot of setup, which is definitely something that Boop like to work on. They like their setup into setup into setup. And it's an Athena hover over here. I like this decision. Athena enabling a lot for Amuzen Carb and Poseidon. We're going to see that locked in right now, ladies and gentlemen. It looks like Dijo's going back to her Kepri. This could be interesting. Kepri has a lot of potential to set up and peel. At the same time, so does Athena. So as a result, this game is going to come down to between Dijo and Mono Sape. Which of these two is going to set up? Athena Taunt is on a 15-second cooldown. That means at minimum every 15 seconds, there's going to be a Taunt thrower. And if Mono can keep throwing that out, ladies and gentlemen, then there's going to be some interesting poke potential, shall we say. And it's really going to come down to positioning, which in this smaller map is a problem. Either way, ladies and gentlemen, let's get you right in to that match. Like we said, finals on the line. This is the last game. Both of these two teams have come here today with this best of five. We are 2-for-2, both these teams. This is it. There are no more second chances as it stands, ladies and gentlemen. We are here for the finals, and here we are in game. So, as I said, it's going to come down to a very interesting early game dynamic, especially for Boopy versus the Elysian Uprising. Boopy, I would say, tend to hold the early game here. I would probably put that there just because Aura does come online a little bit sooner than AMC, but given enough time, red team will be able to take this, and I do think that it's really going to come out of the supports here, ladies and gentlemen. So we're in for a stoozer of a game, and what a season they have put on for us. Both these two teams fought their way through to this, and so now it's going to come down to this. Now, this is an interesting choice coming out from Fireheart Axel. Has gone in for the Sunder already. Now, what this Sunder means to me, this looks like he's potentially looking to fight. Backs off of the choice before it's too late. I think he may instead go, yeah, there's the beads. But the Sunder option there does tip the hand just a little bit on a potential of what they're looking to do. And as always, DJO is there with the laugh spam. Because at the end of the day, what would this be if DJO wasn't going to be spam laughing? This is how they've played a lot of their games for a lot of the early. And again, this I like this positioning here. Seeing that the enemy weren't anywhere near them, they're looking to try and set up around this red buff. Maybe steal away the first two, and it looks like already instant clear. A lot of high clear. It manages to get them just that little bit of bonus XP coming up straight away. If they can hit 4 faster, they'll hit 5 faster. And if they hit 5 faster, then things are going to get interesting. Athena dashes in, gets a 2-man taunt already, but it's more poke onto the Aura from AMC trying to clear out this wave right now. And this is interesting. Though I would have said that there was going to be wave clear coming out from Boopy, it looks like it's still fairly even. So right now it's just trying to exchange the poke, try and win back some ground, Red Team R. And it looks like I said, with that AMC, we have Hives coming around the other side of the walls. And this is really going to be a problem for Boopy to look at. Nice bit of poke onto Poseidon, but right now I'd rather see them focusing the wave right now. If they have potential clear from the wave, they need to get that early. That's what's going to give them pressure in this early stages, because minions doing 30 damage a shot is going to be good. Nice damage onto Aura, but it looks like Aura is going to manage to just get out there with the leap. Med's going to be forced on Athena, and it's a very interesting choice of relic coming out for Red Team here. We actually see a Bracer of the Undoing on Poseidon. Not the most interesting or necessarily the best of choices here, but I can understand where he's going for. Athena goes in, manages to put down a little bit of damage, but no taunt by the looks of it. And it's an interesting option here, is Athena is doing a very useful thing, and that is she's looking to just say, hey, I'm going to keep dashing in at you. Sometimes there'll be a taunt. Other times there won't be a taunt. You burn beads on the wrong one. Very nice coming out, Jackie. Manages to pick up the red buff, and it looks like right now they're gonna try and get it, but they may pay for it. Poseidon drops a whirlpool, and Aura is gonna get taken out. Will they trade out with Poseidon? No, they won't. That was a lot of greed there. They got the red buff, but they just wanted more, and that puts them in a very awkward situation right now. Should get the wave clear, but Poseidon managing to use that Bracer Undoing to give him just enough health. That was big. Honestly, that was a lot of greed coming out from Axel there. They'd already got the buff, they should have been content to take that, but Axel just wanted the buff, and it cost him. Kepri had already done as much peel as physically possible at this point, and still with no ult, only now just dinging 5. You can already see that swing on the grass there. It's 500 gold, pretty much all just from that first blood. Either way though, that's still a fair amount, especially on Athena, who's now already got her full Stone of Gaia. Not necessarily the strongest of options here, but I can understand the reason for it. It's a lot of health, it's a lot of regen to help with any poke potential coming out, and being able to immune one knock-up can be the difference between, well, living and dying, being able to peel for the backline or not. So it's going to be interesting to see exactly how Boopy come back from this. We have Transcendence finished on Brozino, which does mean he's going to be able to start really putting a nice power spike here. Definitely wanting to just use those abilities, get a lot of damage coming out from that. Worry about lifesteal later. If he can get any damage off into the backline, the more potent that's going to be. Poseidon looks like he's going to be looking for that Warlock Sash right now, which is a slightly awkward type. Nice 2-man taunt back into the whirlpool, puts a lot more damage onto DJO, but right now she should be okay. She does have the meditation to keep her alive, but there are people on Boopy needing to back, and it's going to come up to Red Team to really try and pressure to keep them here. We've had people back on Red Team. Use that gold to efficiently build more items, get more damage online, be tankier. DJO still sat with Boots 1 right now, really looking in a bad spot right now, down to about 35% HP. And right now, Red Team are really controlling this, and this is a problem. You cannot give AMC any amount of lane pressure, because if you give AMC lane pressure, it's very difficult to take that away. With Hives spread throughout what looks like the entirety of the map, it's going to be difficult. Axe missed, but a nice shot coming out again. Athena taunts into the backline. Not sure where she was looking for with that. Poseidon comes back, and it looks like right now it's just going to be an exchange of meds, trying to take advantage of a 3v2 situation here, but Poseidon has finished that Warlock Sash now, so it's very difficult for him to get these stacks online, ladies and gentlemen. There's only one lane, and there's not much else for him right now. Athena looking for another taunt. I'm gonna keep saying it. You guys can keep a count back at home as Poseidon ult comes out. Looks like he's gonna get the ultimate off, and indeed he does. Jackie falls down for the second kill on the team. This is awkward now. This is starting to get a little bit out of hand. We see there's a little bit of discommunication coming out from Boopy. We've seen Aura's trying to sit taking away Hives, whereas right now, red team, they've just managed to pick up themselves a red buff, and this time, there's no Hobwa to contest it. So that was a very well-timed fight, knowing that at the end of the day, Jackie just has beads. He doesn't have the Sanctuary to really save himself on that, so as a result, perfect pickoff. There's nothing Hobwa could do in that situation. Looks like he's going in for some more lifesteal. Could see the Book of the Dead, or we could also as well see the Bancroft style. And both of these items recently saw a change. Nice stun onto Muzin Karb, and Jackie picks up the kill, not respecting the damage coming out from Aura or Hobwa in that situation. Very nice turnaround kill, but that all comes down from that burst that Aura's got. And he's going to come online a little bit faster than AMC, suffering a death now. But those two assists and the team being ahead, he should be okay. Poseidon's going to look to pick up his blue buff. He's going to get shown. Jackie's actually going to go over the wall, sorry. And it looks like he might pick him up. Brace of Undoing comes out. Whirlpool goes down as well. And Athena manages to pick off enough of the damage and keep him safe. That was interesting. And that came all just from knowing that Tattle Shard was through the wall. So now it's just going to be the supports trying to do some damage to each other. But it's not really too much. It's just going to be a little bit more of a farm fest. We'll take a quick look over to the graphs. The game is still relatively even, only about 500 gold from First Blood being the main point here. Everything else pretty much tied up. So now it's going to be interesting as we see more damage coming through again. Lovely disengage. This is red team looking to try and take the advantage that they have of, hey, there are more of us here. Let's just poke them out. So it's going to be interesting to see whether or not they can keep that pressure. Full boots for Poseidon coming along now. So he's definitely going to start really ratcheting up that mobile. And it is a Bancroft's Talon coming out for Jackie here. I like Bancroft's Talon. The idea is, hey, it's a boatload of power. Hey, it's a boatload of sustain. Very nice axe. Gonna get pulled in. Amuzin Karb not gonna be able to survive this one. Fireheart picks up the kill, giving him a 5 more stacks onto that Devourer's Gauntlet. And it looks like he is the focus here. Nice pre-piece, just trying to clear out the way. Poseidon getting slowed and pulled in this time. Ooh, big ultimate comes through, and Fireheart manages to pick up the second kill. And this is what Boopy have always done. They have always been this tight-knit group who, if you get CC from any single one of them, they'll all follow up, and chances are, in this case, they've managed to pick up another kill. And unfortunately, it's just Athena here trying to do her best to clear the wave until AMC gets back. He's back now, but he is a level down on anyone on Boopy, so that is a very awkward situation for them to be in as it stands. He's working on that Haze of Vitala, so he doesn't have too much sustain. He's going to be looking to try and use any of the bees right now, and Athena again just constantly going in. Misses the taunt thanks to a nice bit of positioning from Dejo, but again, Athena is aggressive, and this is working out for this comp right now. As again, Hobwa is going to take a lot of damage. Meditation comes through, manages to save him. Kepri gets stunned, but it's still a Kepri at the end of the day, and it looks like right now, Kepri's going to go in, manages to pull Athena. Athena's taking a few shots from the tower, but she's going to be okay for now. Stinger comes out on a Muzin Karb. Skara's Blessing, though, should deter the rest of the damage coming through as Kepri again manages to save not one, but two members of the team. What does this do, though? This gives a lot of pressure for Red Team. Red Team are going to get a nice bit of clear. They should be able to, again, secure this red buff. The timing of these fights has been perfectly centered around red buffs up, force them out, get red buff. If they can constantly take 2 out of 3 buffs, they're going to pull out more and more of a lead. Not to mention pushing more stuff into tower, they'll eventually chip away at this lead, and any lead that is created is going to diminish. Aura very far up right now. Didn't think necessarily that there was going to be an AMC right there. Kepri gets pulled back in. Tidal Surge knocks him further away out of more damage. Should be okay right now, but again, it's just this utility coming out from Poseidon. Oh, here's a whirlpool. Oh, Athena's making you walk into it? Fair enough then, take more damage. So it's a very awkward situation that Boopy have found themselves in, and I do feel that it's really going to come down to... Ooh, Aura manages to get a nice bit of damage off, and Muzin Karb goes down. Jackie decides to lend in a water hand or two over there. The spout manages to flush out the bug. If you had to choose, I suppose water does beat bugs. I mean, Itsy Bitsy Spider, she went down the drain. So, you know, there's an awkward bit of that. But either way, This Hawar really starting to put a lot of damage in. Don't know whether or not we're going to see a Soul Reaver, or we could see a Book of Toph. It's still fairly early, and the Thoth Starks aren't as impactful. Poseidon just deleted. One axe is all it takes. Bracer of Undoing can't save you from that much burst, I'm afraid. Meditation Force, as again, Boopy are looking to really try and fight. This has been one of the most aggressive games we have seen coming out from either of these two teams. So they sure know how to please the audience, ladies and gentlemen. Either way, another great, fantastic combo. Aegis comes out, and Defender of Olympus for the first time we get to see. Thinazol forced, but Thinazol isn't necessarily too impactful in terms of mobility or getting her around the map. It's a much smaller map, so as a result, instead, she's really just looking to use that for the protections. Trying to find out Aura, doesn't manage to get him, unfortunately. So, manages to get back, and again, DJO is just taunting. Gotta hit that VET every time, man. Gotta put them all on tilt, because if you can put them on tilt, and they make a stupid decision, one fight, that's all it takes, is one fight right now. Ooh, very nice taunt coming out. Aura is looking to try and poke out with AMC right now. Poseidon's in the backline, finds the ultimate, but Scarab's Blessing should be able to keep Hubwa in the back, safe and sound. And unfortunately, that does mean, again, we're down to a 2v3. This team comp isn't necessarily just about the 100-0 potential. If they don't kill you, you've got a base. And if you have to base, that puts them in a very awkward situation. I would like to see a transition over towards the Fire Giant in a short period of time. But Gem of Isolation has now been picked up. Two-man Taunt forces the beads on Axel. This is not good for Team Boopy right now. Looks like right now I would definitely have to get the advantage going over to Red Team right now. They just have more control, honestly, and it does come down to control. This Athena is constantly dashing in, constantly making it like, hey, I'm gonna taunt you at some point. And the cripple coming out from Poseidon Whirlpool, unless Hubwa can throw his Atlas of the Yellow River through that, that slow is going to just destroy both Dejo and Axel. Can't leap out, can't dash out to get any more damage. So, and even if they do force the ult from Dejo, there's no CDR outside of boots. That's a very small amount, and is again going straight back in. This Athena Mono Sape has been just constantly all up in the faces of a Hubwa and an Uhura, and that, ladies and gentlemen, takes some serious gonads. Meditation popped out from Athena again, just trying to keep the team healthy. Again, another dash, unfortunately misses the taunt, but giving the team this much freedom, giving the team this much room to maneuver really hurts. Uhura caught out over on the right-hand side, misses the axe, gonna take a trade with Poseidon, manages to take it even through the Kraken. Very nice play coming out there, really knowing the damage numbers and hitting them as well. Thinarok comes through more so for the mobility this time. Has gone in for a Mystical Mail, and this is an interesting option here. This is going to allow Athena to do a little bit more damage as she's all up in the face of everyone on Boopy right now. Being able to just be in the faces, putting that additional 40 magical damage is actually pretty nice, especially when it comes to fighting against someone like an Uhura. And as we saw there, that Stone of Gaia also actually procs on Khepri Pulp. It's not something that necessarily a lot of people know, but it is a very nice mechanic piece coming out right now. As now it's coming out into a man fight between Aura and the AMC. It looks like he's managed to get the trade. Sanctuary is popped. Can he find the last basic? Can't find the Hail of Arrows. Can't find the bladed arrow. That's gotta be awkward. Looks like right now Fireheart is gonna trade his life out. And unfortunately, Monoscape does manage to pick up the kill as well. Poseidon has turned up. Manages to get a fair chunk of damage into Hubwa, but there's a little bit of lifesteal. Can he be able to really hold it? No, looks like he's gonna force his beads as well. This Athena is doing work as Jackie just falls down to the Poseidon. Slows too strong, man. Slows way too strong. And now this just really opens up this game, putting it in favor of Red Team. We can see they've really taken a dent on this gold difference. XP is still fairly close. And honestly, the later this game goes, the better it's going to be for Red Team. Yes, Hubwa in the late game hits like four trucks. He has four ultimates and has been always known as the god of four ultimates. But that isn't going to matter if he's constantly being aggressed on by an Athena, if he's constantly going to taunt. It doesn't matter. He can't do anything if Athena's all up in his face and then there's just a Poseidon Kraken. Both of them have now finished off their Obsidian Shards. They are going to get a lot of damage. Cheeky bit of damage going over from Bruzzoni, looking to try and steal away the buff. I think he actually got that. Did he pick it up? No, it does look like that Hubwa managed to get it. He's going to come around now as Uhura is really trying to be aggressive 1v3 right now. Habois ultimate completely off the mark there, unfortunately, and now that's putting him in an awkward situation. AMC looking to chase out Fireheart Axel over on the left-hand side, but it's not a trade that he's wanting to take right now. Fireheart picks up the clean 1v1, but it looks like Aegis is going to get popped there, keeps him alive, and now it's all just going to be about picking off one by one by one. Boopy have managed to secure themselves a 2v3, and it looks like right now it's just a 2v1. Athena stuck all by her lonesome. Mystical Mare is going to do work, but it's going to take a lot more than that. Sprint and Meditation pop. She's kiting right now, but it looks like the cult is going to get it. Stun and there we go. There we go. Finally, Axel manages to pick up the kill, but she did buy a lot of time there. Brozoni is now back, so a lot of pressure there has actually been saved by Athena managing to just spin around in circles, and sometimes that's what you need to do. Sometimes you know that the team is going to kill you, so your goal is not to necessarily survive. If you can, that's amazing. Your goal is to spend as much time as possible, wasting as much of their time as possible. You see more CDR coming out for this Athena. This Athena really wants to just be, hey, I'm just gonna constantly throw out more and more and more taunts. What is interesting now, though, is this lack of CDR coming out from AMC. AMC definitely is a strong god for boxing, so even the small amount is useful. Aura leaps over the wall, manages to get the stun onto Poseidon, and the burst goes through. Kepri pulls it up, and even with almost a fully stacked Warlock Sash and the Gem of Isolation, the burst coming out from Aura is just insane. It is absolutely insane, and now this level disparity is starting to get just a little bit awkward. 8-2-2. Fireheart Axel has been literally everywhere with who he's been putting damage into. In fact, actually, if we just take a quick look at the damage numbers here, I believe, if we just take a quick look, 16,698, sitting a flat 4,000 above the next highest, and that's a Habois. He is a flat 7,000 above anyone on the enemy team, as right now Aura is in a bit of an awkward situation. Beast Force, Skyro's Blessing Force, really wanting to try and just back right now, unfortunately, not being let up. Kepri forcing out the weakening, or the enfeebling curse, as it were. Horrific Emblem is now known. Meditations have been popped. Poseidon's really taking a beating right now. Aura has returned to this fight, but Athena's going to keep him busy. Jackie picks up the kill, finally, on Arkidu, as right now he picks up a double kill on Monoscape, unfortunately. That's just awkward. That was a very awkward fight. They had a lot of damage pumped into the Aura, chased him out 2v1, but unfortunately Brozoni just not able to punch in any damage at all. And Jackie comes in, a lot of nice body blocks coming out from Dejo, really keeping him busy. And as a result, just, they decimated the fight. You put an Athena against an Aura, Aura's gonna be able to take that trade, especially when Athena hasn't built any form of damage outside of what you can argue is Mystical Mail ticks, which is going to get out DPS. So as a result, that's just going to crumble. Tower finally falls down here at the 17-minute mark, tipping in almost to 18. Aura taking a little bit of damage there, getting a bit nervous there, thinking he was going to have to Sanctuary. The taunt is going to really put a lot of damage. Habois going to taunt his way through everything. But right now, it's more just a case of stripping away buffs and trying to just push as much damage in as they can. Aura manages to put through a lot of damage into AMC. He is really, really taking a lot of damage right now. And there he goes, another kill the way. Poseidon now is the next on the target, as Knockup kills both of them. Arcano takes out Fireheart Axel, leaving Kepri alone. But now in comes the Habois. He's really looking for that Poseidon. Knockup hit, almost deletes him fully. Athena gets in the way, manages to force out the Sanctuary, but it's going to come down to the Whirlpool. Nope, never mind. Jackie picks it up with a Water Spout after using that Crushing Wave. And Crushing Wave is starting to hit like a truck now. Level 3 on that ultimate. This has gone from a, oh, it's a bit of water, to this does half my health. So right now they're just wasting as much time as they can, trying to take out Athena, and then it should be a Bull Demon King. Nice body block coming out from the Habois there. Looks like they might be able to finally find it. Then it's just one more auto. Oh no, it'll take it out. But Brozoni now has respawned with that lower level, means that he does now have that increased lower respawn timer. And it has been, oh, wow. Our hero was, he's gone. That, try not to consider how fleeting this moment of joy is. That was a lot of damage. Habois with almost a fully stacked Bukatov plus a Rod of Tahuti. That is a lot of damage. That is... I don't have words for it. That's just a lot of damage, ladies and gentlemen. You are sitting at 280 plus 290, so that's a lot. Plus like 140 scaling, minimum. That's a lot. So Brozoni really needs to work on that positioning right now, and unfortunately this AMC pick really hasn't been able to offer that. We've actually seen two meditations coming out to try and deal with this burst from Jackie right now. Both Poseidon and Monoscape picking this up. It's definitely an option that I don't think is necessarily going to work out. You know, really trying to put as much damage into the tower as possible, but I'm just not seeing it right now. As Aura manages to walk down Poseidon, this should be a clean, easy kill. Bracer Band doing pop. Whirlpool popped. There goes the ultimate. Stinger has been popped. Everything's just getting popped, but right now Aura is still alive. Scarab's Blessing gets popped. Jackie picks up the kill. Defender of Olympus isn't going to get anywhere right now. And now it's all up to that Poseidon. Poseidon is gone, and Monoscape, there's nothing Monoscape can do. It's just come down to clean picks, high teamwork, and it's just now this Hobwash show. Athena gonna try and waste as much time as possible. Axel's gonna try and chase it down, but right now Monoscape really just not gonna be able to get away. Hobwa manages to pick up the final CC to put the nail in the coffin, and now this should be a Phoenix, and we could very well see game here, but Brozoni is up. It's gonna be interesting to see. He does have that higher crit now online. He's finished his Deathbringer, but really, we need sustain. Sustain comes out from it. Firehackle goes in, manages to hit the chain, and Jackie just deletes him with the harder hands, ladies and gentlemen. And now, these level disparities, when you're hitting harder, and being able to just tank up more damage as they're farming fountain kills. This could potentially be a throw. We've seen people do this before, as Hobwa has to force his Aegis, worrying about the damage coming out from Poseidon, but it's full build time now, ladies and gentlemen, pretty much for everyone on the team, except Brozoni. It's more about the XP right now, so gold means basically nothing. It's gonna be a big Kraken coming out, but it just doesn't do any damage. Hobwa forcing out more damage in the backside. The Scarab's Blessing comes down, really just trying to deter damage, but it might not be enough as Aura falls down, but Brozoni manages to pick up the kill. Jackie comes through with that crushing wave, is now divine, but gets shut down as Arcado comes through with a double kill. This could be a turnaround. We've seen teams throw, and right now, this should most definitely be an easy pickup on this Phoenix right now. If nothing else, this should just be at the tier 1 tower and then go straight for Fire Giant. Everyone on the team is dead for 30 seconds. Hell, this could even be the game, ladies and gentlemen. We don't know. We've seen these teams do phenomenal things. AMC has damage now. He has his attack speed online. He's going to be able to start shredding through once he manages to pick up a little bit more pen. They could go for this. Meditation is popped on Poseidon, and Athena's coming through with Defender of Olympus. This could be the turnaround, ladies and gentlemen. All from one team fight, just overextending as AMC dies to the Phoenix. But with two people coming up now, Axel and Dijo, this is going to be a difficult one. Axel's looking out for blood here, ladies and gentlemen. He's not going to be able to find it. Dijo is being kept busy out by Monosave, but right now, it's just a complete 180. A complete 180. This entire game, Boopy have held it. They've held the XP lead. They've held the gold lead. But right now, just one fight, one wipe, and they're already down to even, ladies and gentlemen. Athena is not going to be able to get away from there, but does manage to force the horrific emblem. But this is insane. I have no words for this. Poseidon now has got his power pot online. He has got his blink ritual to be able to get him out of any danger if he needs to. And right now, he has Kraken online. They have Brozy. He is up. He has triple crit right now. Who needs sustain? In this game, he's going to be binary. He's either going to be dead or alive. He knows what his job is right now, and that's to get in and delete the squishies. If he can throw a crit out onto Hobwa and half hit him, and Hobwa half hits him back, well, it's an even trade right now. So this is going to be... this is on a knife edge now. One team fight. One pick is all that matters right now, ladies and gentlemen. The Phoenix has respawned for red team, so they do now hold a little bit of advantage. The last fire wave is going to be coming up. So right now, I'm looking to Athena. I'm saying, hey, Athena, go and get me a taunt. Get me a taunt on Kepri. It doesn't matter. You get me a taunt on Kepri, we'll deal with the rest of them right now. But this is so close, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, this is the final of your summer 3v3 tournament here at Hi-Rez. These two teams have worked so incredibly hard all day, and it hinges on potentially one team fight. I have no words for this right now. This is tense. This is really tense. And it looks like right now Boopy are just looking to try and burn out anything they can. They're looking for a little bit of positioning right now. They may be vying to try and grab a demon right now. If they can get this Bull Demon King, it's going to either force red team out, or they're going to have to try and look to get some positioning, as right now Bull Demon is being aggressed right now. Aura chunking for 300 an auto right now. They do get this, and this could be potentially the thing that they need. That regen really going to be able to help them and let them get dive. Dijo trying to keep him busy on the backline as Aura makes his way around to the side. He has Titan's Bane, so this should be a very easy Phoenix. Backdoor protections don't even matter right now. Kepri takes a lot more damage than necessarily she wanted, but it's okay as Poseidon manages to blink out. Is he going to be able to get away? Two ults go, two meds go through. The ult comes through, but it's not going to be enough. He does still fall. Brony takes him out, picks up a double kill right now as they may be able to turn this. It's 2v1. Hawaii falls right now, ladies and gentlemen, and that could be game. One team fight goes the wrong way. Sprint is popped. They're charging down the lane. Nobody matters. That was a phenomenal fight. Surrender vote goes out. Could this be game, ladies and gentlemen? There's 30 seconds left on Dijo. AMC has this. AMC has the damage for this. Athena's here to be able to tank this. They're going to do it. After spending the entire game, ladies and gentlemen, on the back foot, the entire game, one team fight. One team fight turns this game on its head, and Boopy throw the game at the last second. Red team come out with the turnaround of the entire tournament, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to Red Team. Monoscape, Arcady, and Bronzy will be taking home that trophy for them. Commiserations to Boopy. This was one hell of a tournament, ladies and gentlemen. This has been one hell of a set, and it has been an absolute honor to cast. My name has been Supersonic Blur. Thank you very much for watching, and we shall see you all next time here on Hi-Rez TV.